Welcome to the Movie in Minutes. Today, I will show you an action-adventure movie. Title, Black Widow. Watch out and take care. In 1995, Super Soldier Alexei Shostakov and Black Widow Melina Vostokov, Russian undercover agents, pose as a family in Ohio with their surrogate daughters Natasha Romanoff and Yelena Belova. After finishing their mission to steal SHIELD intel, they escape to Cuba and rendezvous with their boss, General Dreykov, who has Romanoff and Belova taken to the Red Room for training. Years pass, during which Shostakov is imprisoned in Russia while Romanoff defects to SHIELD after bombing Dreykov's Budapest office, apparently killing him and his young daughter Antonia. In 2016, Romanoff is a fugitive for violating the Sokovia Accords. She escapes from U.S. Secretary of State Thaddeus Ross and flees to a safe house in Norway supplied by Rick Mason. Meanwhile, Belova kills a rogue former Black Widow but comes in contact with a synthetic gas that neutralizes the Red Room's chemical mind control agent. Belova sends antidote vials to Romanoff, hoping she will sense the Avengers to free the other widows. When Romanoff unknowingly drives off with the vials, Taskmaster attacks her seeking them. Romanoff manages to escape Taskmaster and realizes that they came from Belova. The two reunite in Budapest. Romanoff learns Dreykov is alive and the Red Room is still active. Shortly after, Black Widows attack them. Romanoff and Belova evade them and Taskmaster before meeting Mason, who supplies them with a helicopter. Romanoff and Belova break Shostakov out of prison to learn Dreykov's location. He tells them to speak with Vostokov, who lives on a farm outside St. Petersburg, where she developed the chemical mind control process used on the widows. There, Belova reveals that while they were not a real family, she believed they were so. Afterward, Vostokov admits she sent their location to Dreykov. His agents arrive and take them to the Red Room, an aerial facility. Vostokov and Romanoff use face mask technology to switch places before being captured, allowing Vostokov to free Shostakov and Belova from their restraints. Meanwhile, Romanoff confronts Dreykov, who sees through her disguise. Romanoff learns Taskmaster is Antonia, who suffered damage severe enough that Dreykov had to put a chip in her head. This made her the perfect soldier, capable of mimicking the actions of anyone she sees. Romanoff attempts to kill Dreykov but fails to harm him due to a pheromone lock installed in every widow. Dreykov reveals that he controls widows worldwide via his desk console. Romanoff intentionally breaks her nose, severing a nerve in her nasal passage to negate the pheromone, and then attacks Dreykov. Shostakov battles Taskmaster, while Vostokov takes out one of the facility's engines and Belova searches for the other widows, who have been sent to protect Dreykov. Together, Shostakov and Vostokov lock Taskmaster in a cell. Dreykov escapes as the widows attack Romanoff, but Belova creates an antidote bomb that releases the widows from mind control. Romanoff gets into the control desk and copies the locations of the other widows worldwide as the facility begins to explode and fall. Romanoff retrieves the two surviving vials of the antidote and frees Taskmaster from the locked cell. Vostokov and Shostakov escape via a plane while Belova takes out Dreykov's aircraft, killing him. In free fall, Romanoff gives Belova a parachute before battling Taskmaster. After landing, Romanoff uses one antidote vial on Taskmaster, freeing her from servitude. The freed widows arrive as Belova, Vostokov, and Shostakov say goodbye to Romanoff. She gives Belova the last antidote vial and the portable drive, telling her to find and free the other, still mind-controlled, widows. As they leave with Antonia, Romanoff awaits Ross and his men, who have arrived to apprehend her. 2 weeks later, a now-blonde Romanoff reunites with Mason, who supplies her with a Quinjet. She leaves, intending to free the imprisoned Avengers. In a post-credits scene set after Romanoff's death, Belova encounters Valentina Allegra de Fontaine at Romanoff's grave. De Fontaine assigns Clint Barton, whom she claims is responsible for Romanoff's death, as Belova's next target. Make sure to subscribe and turn on the notifications so you can watch more video like this. Thank for watching.